Yeah, this is he. How can I help you?
Hey, Felipe, Claude Diamond gave me your phone number. My name is Brian Bagnell. How are you?
I'm doing great. I'm about to be better. You know, like if Claude gave you my number, it better be a money call. So talk to me. What's in it for me?
It is. I'll cut to the chase. I got a first position note that we're looking to fund. It's $200,000 on a $300,000 house. So you got a lot of padding there. It's at 6%. I know that's probably not super high, but it's got a lot of padding there. And we're looking to put a nice family in there and help them qualify for it, do some owner financing for them and all that. So not sure if that would be of interest to you, but that's what I got.
Let me see if I get this straight. You got a note at 6% on a house that it's worth 300,000, and the note is for 200. You're trying to get them qualified so they can. Is it what, like a rent to own, or what are we talking about here?
Yeah, it's a contract for deed. We do a 2-year balloon. We always ask for a little more time though. We just want to be a person of our word and obviously make our payments to you on time and that kind of stuff. So once in a while, we can't get them financed within two years. Maybe they need a little extra time. Maybe we need to get somebody else in there. But yeah, it's a really nice family that kind of been through a little bit of a rough patch. They were caught in a hurricane and just trying to rebuild and that kind of stuff. They're not deadbeats or anything like that. So.
And tell me how you and I are gonna make money on this deal, because it all sounds great, but if you need to help a family, why don't you join the Peace Corps? I mean,
That's what
real
they would
talk.
say.
You're gonna listen, money always gets the last look.
That's true.
And you need to tune in the favorite radio station. What's in it for me? WINFM or something like that. No, for real. It's like, hey, and Claude was doing this, meaning you got to push my hot button, and my hot button is greed.
Greed, yeah.
I mean,
true.
I couldn't care less. I mean, to be honest, I couldn't care less about this family. I care
Yeah.
about how secure. How secure is going to be my investment? What's my return?
Gotcha.
And how I mean, why should I do business with you? I mean, why you and why now?
Gotcha.
So yeah, I mean, it all sounds great, but you know, like I mean, Brian, and you sound like a great guy. And if Claude gave you my number, it's probably for a reason, because you know you're it tells me something about your character. But I get too many of these calls every day. I get somebody pitching me about a rent to own deal, first lien position and all that. Why should I, put 200,000 on this deal?
Hey, I understand. I appreciate your honesty too. It's something that's kind of missing in today's world. So I appreciate you shooting straight with me, and I'll shoot straight with you. So yeah, 6%, it may not be that great. What would make you excited about doing this deal?
I mean, right now with the current market, I'm looking at anywhere between 9 to 12%. I mean, that's just what it is.
Gotcha. Can we get you at 8?
Let's pretend I say yes to that. What are the terms?
Terms, we would it'd be 6% amortized over 15 years, and we can do a 5-year balloon.
Okay.
What happened
How
to
much?
8?
Yeah.
So, what
You
did I
said
say?
six.
Oh, sorry.
You're
I was saying what we did before. Sorry. You're absolutely right. We agreed on 8%. I
good.
usually do 6% with these deals, and I was just on that track. But sorry, 8%, 5-year balloon, 15-year amortization.
Oof, man. I mean, I'm almost regretting this while I'm saying it, but let's say for a minute, let's say that it's Friday. I'm in a very good mood, even if all my 3 kids tested positive for COVID, which is no joke. Let's say I would agree. I'm not saying I can, to a 9% with a 2-year balloon. What would you tell him? What would you say to me next?
You off the role play. That you sound so much like me when we were doing the same role play. I took the 5 years and I got it down to 3, and instead of 6%, I said I want 12, and then I accepted 9.5 or something.
Yeah.
Same role play. You did the same moves I did.
Yeah, and the thing is this is that, remember, like my hot button, it's greed, and as an investor, if you need me to put skin in the game, it's how soon am I gonna get my principal back, how secure I am,
Ooh.
and what's my like, again,
What's your exit plan?
Yeah, what's your exit strategy? Because the thing is, you mentioned something about the family, that they're in a bad spot in their life and all that. And it's in exactly boo F and who things. And the what you need to, again, it's always without lying, but present it in a way where, okay, no, this deal makes a lot of sense for me. I definitely want to put money into it. And total transparency, and like, and again, a guy that has the money is going to try to say, hey, why should I work with you? And then at that point, it's a good time to be assertive and say, like, you know what, that's a great question. I like a straight shooter like you. I don't know, maybe you shouldn't, but Claude gave me your number. He told me that, no, you're the man to talk to, that you're buying notes in that area. The house is great. He's going to appreciate, I don't know, 10, 15% in the next 3 years. So, and I have 9 other people to call. I just wanted to give you the first look because, you know, Claude gave me your number. But so should we talk about doing a deal together, or should I get lost? Because I mean, I'm too busy. It's not F me, it's F you. Yeah. No, but now you got my attention. Now you got my attention. Now I was like, okay, no, just tell. And you see, I'm going to try to, now I'm trying to treat you like a child. And now you become assertive and we level up, and now we can talk like two adults. And
how about that one line? I heard Brian, there was one line, how do I know I can trust you, or something like that?
I don't know, maybe you should.
And you did, and Brian did very well with it, but there's another way to hand, you know, or why should I do business with you? I think that's what it was.
Yeah, why should I work with you now? I mean, I get so many calls like this.
Maybe you shouldn't, sir. You know what? Claude asked me to call you. You should only work with me if you want to make a lot of money, with an established company, a safe investment, a good rate of return. I'm sorry, I can't give you 9-10%, but I can give you a solid 6%. You'll get a check every month. You have access, or, you know, we can do a lot of different things, and we get some great deals, sir. So if that's not what you're looking for, then you shouldn't do business with me. How do you feel about that?
You guys are too smooth for me.
No,
Oh, I know, this is great.
People that are in a position of, I mean, that have money, I mean, they're gonna, some of them are gonna try to bully you. Some of them are just gonna make you plain and simple waste your time.
Yeah.
So that's why.
Negative redirection, sometimes positive. When they hit you with, well, why should I work with you, or who, I'm working with Joe Blow or anybody, then you do a positive redirection. The other way, but you always open it up to for more dialogue, or like you don't need them.
Yeah,
that social proof and that scarcity, they work together like peanut butter and jam. They really do.
I don't want to take up your call here, Felipe. I appreciate.
No, I mean it. I mean, I love that. I love sometimes to these calls that overlap, because I mean, to me, like I said, like I'm already doing deals on real estate. Thank God it pays the bills. That's good. You know, of course it has a lot of challenges keeping, you know, holding salespeople accountable, but what really I enjoy the most is the sales training part, you know, working with people that are like, that are invested in getting better, like you, like, you know, other mentees. So this is, to me, it's great practice, because like most of my sessions with Claude, it's not about doing real estate deals. It's like, we did that for the first 2-3 years.
Life. Now, it's life. It's life.
It's
man.
Mindset. It's like fine tuning in these role plays. And like, believe me, it's like, I make so many mistakes when it comes to closing these deals. I'm like, so yeah, it happens.
Cool. Well, thank you so much, guys.
You haven't closed me yet. You
have a good weekend.
Haven't closed to you yet? Yeah.
30 seconds.
Well, you know, there's a lot of people you can go with, right? Maybe they can get you higher returns. You know, if that is what it is. But, you know, if you want someone that's going to pay you on time, that's not going to bullshit you, that we can do a lot of business together in the future. You know, that's me. But, you know, maybe I'm not the best guy for you.
That's great. Just added a little twist. Like, and ask me, why do you think that while other people are paying 9 to 12%, people come to me and they're okay with 6 or 7%? Take a guess. You're a smart man. And and my logical question is going to be no, because probably you know, your word is your bond, you pay on time, you know, I never had to, you know, get attorneys involved and all that. Whatever the answer, exactly. That's exactly what it is.
Exactly.
And then you just go from there and now I'm becoming an authority. I mean, you're becoming an authority and I'm like, okay, you see, somebody pitched me a deal for 9 to 12%, but it was Joe Blow from, you know, East Bumble. And I got this guy that came highly recommended and he's offering me 6, but I feel comfortable with him. So I'll give you my money. So that's it.
Well, go, Felipe, give me your money. We got to fund some deals.
So. The best thing you can do is act like you don't need it.
Yeah, totally.
Like you're giving him a rare opportunity and you got to play that role. If you come begging, They're gonna work, question your credibility.
Yeah.
Okay. Hey, listen, sir, I'd love to, you know what? We're getting so many deals with so many and we've never seen it like this before. And I'm looking for more, you know, capital, frankly, so we can make more money and we can help investors like you have secure investments also in a return. Right now we're overwhelmed. We have so many deals. And, you know, we're a small family run business and we stand on our reputation. I mean, Brian must have referred you to me for a reason. What was that?
I don't know. Maybe because she thinks that then, you know, that you can help me make more money.
I can only help you make 6%, but it's secure, it's safe, and it's a hell of a lot more than the bank.
Oof. I mean, can you send me a prospectus and I'll get back to you by 4 o'clock this afternoon?
I can send you whatever you want, sir. Let me ask you something. If you and I'll send you everything you want. If you and I have a meeting of the minds at 4:30 today, are you in a liquid position to do this transaction? And do you have the authority?
Yeah. We're liquid. Actually, we're looking to place some money. We got a couple of 1031 exchanges, you know, that we need to place as soon as possible. So this would probably be right on my alley. It's just, I want to know how secure I'm going to be and, you know, like the
return. I don't blame you. Anything you need, sir, we're an open book. I can give you references. You can check our credit or Dun & Bradstreet rating, whatever you need. I'll talk to you at 4:30. And if this isn't right for you, don't have any hesitation to tell me to get lost. I have plenty of other people I can call. So don't worry about it.
You see how poised he is, how relaxed and confident.
Yeah,
that's the kind of person you want to deal with.
Yeah,
true. He's getting off. When he gets off the phone, he'll say, "Hold."